Many times down through the years, I've told you folks just how great wrestling's been to me and my family. Folks, do you think that we don't realize how fortunate we are to have a beautiful ranch like this? Wrestling certainly helped make it possible. Now, folks, I'd like to introduce you to my family. This is Chris. It's my youngest. Michael Britt, Kerry Jean, Mama Doris, my oldest Kevin Ross. Let's not forget the wonder dog Julio. This program is dedicated, folks, from my family to yours.
One, two, three, and Kevin is the American heavyweight champion. David Von Erich says, cover him, Dad, cover him.
And Michael Von Erich wins his professional wrestling debut. Kerry's got him. Here's the Delta pin. Go! Play! The dream comes true! Yes!
Wrestling, who would you say is the greatest wrestler of all time?
That's a rather leading question, don't you think? Now, what do you think the answer is going to be there?
I would say Fritz Von Erich. Von Erich back for the Iron Claw.
You don't like the way I wrestle, Fletcher. Get yourself another life. You disagree with me. I'll be very happy to accommodate you anytime.
Hi, folks. I'm Fritz Von Erich.
Oh, did you see? Fritz Von Erich and the master of the Iron Claw catches Joe Blanchard coming off the rope and is applying the Iron Claw to him right now. Blood's oozing from Joe Blanchard's head as Fritz applies that pressure here in the center of this room. Matt.
And this is where the Von Erich legend began. Right here in the Sportatorium, the most famous wrestling arena in the world. It was more than just a career that was born here. It was a way of life. The life of my children, my lovely wife, Doris. Great matches. Many, many matches. My youngsters. Moments in their lives. Moments in the life of my sweet little wife, Doris. The love of God in our family, the love for each other, the love for you, our fans, and the love of wrestling. All these are tremendous. We're going to share with you some very important moments in the Von Erich life. We hope that you enjoy this as much as the boys and I have enjoyed making it. See you down the road.
Well, my dad was a great father. Now, the Bible says, spare the rod, spoil the child. Let me tell you, my dad followed that to the T. If I did something wrong, well, he'd have a size 12 waiting for my keister when I came home.
To my brothers and I, my dad is a man's man. He's a man that will never go back on his word. When he tells somebody something, that's the way it is. I don't think you'll ever see a man in your life like my father that loves the Lord as much as he does, loves his family as much as he does, and gosh, just loves life as much as he does.
And looking back over my career, I've had over 6,000 professional matches in the ring. I must have battled only thousands of foes, and not all of them were in the ring. I remember the names of these guys just like it was yesterday. People like Kaniski, Johnny Valentine, Bobo Brazil, the Funk Brothers, Terry and Dory, not to mention their old dad, old Dory Sr. People and fans are always asking me which were my most important matches. Well, it'd be real hard for me to pick out just a few. I had many a great match, many a big match, a lot of great memories there. But the one match that I guarantee you that stood out the most in my mind was my retirement match at Texas Stadium before over 30,000 fans back in the summer of 1982.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me again explain the stipulations of this match. This is for the American Heavyweight Championship, a belt that Fritz von Erich at one time held longer than any other human being in the history of wrestling.
Which I now hold.
No disqualification, no time limit. There must be a winner. King Kong Bundy's manager, Gary Hart, is barred from the Texas Stadium field. And falls will be legal either in the ring or on the Dallas Cowboys football field. For the American Heavyweight Championship from Nome, Alaska, at 450 pounds, defending champion King Kong Bundy. Retiring tonight from professional wrestling after an illustrious career. From Lake Dallas, Texas, at 270 pounds, the immortal Fritz von Erich.
Bring the bell, man.
Join the tutoring and the training of an H&H organization that he jumps on Fritz von Erich before he has his jacket off, his shirt off. But here comes Fritz right back, and this battle is underway for the American Heavyweight Championship. Fritz von Erich retiring. King Kong Bundy has the title. Bundy has the claw put on his forehead here early in the bout by Fritz von Erich. But it's ripped loose by Bundy, and we're underway with a bout that'll go all over the stadium.
Effective way to break any hole. A rake across the eyes, Fritz down on one knee. Bundy taking an early upper hand in the mat.
450 pounds. A lumberjack type of man. Bundy with a drop in the throat. He may put him away early. One. Fritz. Get that right shoulder up. And a count of one twice. But it is a claw in the midsection. The abdominal claw by Fritz von Erich, but this is a tough way to put it on.
Not much leverage laying on his back. He needs to get up, have the man he has the claw on his back. Fritz von Erich trying to get some leverage, trying to get up on his feet to get any kind of effective usage out of this iron claw, a hold that he is the master of.
He perfected it. He taught it to his son. Kicks Bundy away as Bundy trying to break the hole. And a big hammer of King Kong Bundy. Fritz battered in the corner, but he comes right off the rope. Fritz von Erich, 28 years of wars in the ring across this nation, in Japan, the Orient, and in Europe. A man who is revered in Japan for his wrestling ability.
Very popular abroad, Bill. This man's known all over the world, not only in the United States. He almost had the count of three there, only two and a half. Bundy showing enormous strength to throw Fritz off the pin.
Now Fritz von Erich. In fact, he is so revered in Japan that dignitaries have come in from the Orient to witness this bout tonight. Japanese photographers are here taking pictures of this bout. Now look at Fritz von Erich coming underneath, blowing across the top of the head of King Kong Bundy.
I don't feel Bundy's the same wrestler without Hussein or Hart ringside, letting them know, letting them get involved or whatever it takes for Hart and Hussein to influence Bundy, but he's missing that tonight, and it's very evident, Bill.
As Bundy now tries to incapacitate Fritz, working on his left arm. Von Erich looking for the claw again, drives it, Bundy stops it. But Bundy, even though he has stopped it, seems to be in trouble. He can't seem to be in command of this bout at all. As you pointed out, he undoubtedly loses some of his effectiveness by him not having someone around the ring telling him how it should be done.
Sometimes when we see a fighter fight off the claw to the head, it's very vulnerable to the midsection. A great...
Well,
Fritz breaking the rules a little, seeing him.
Bending him there a little bit.
Just a little, but it's one last time, a last hurrah for this legend of professional wrestling, 28 years in the business, Fritz Von Erich.
Well, he said, too, before the bout, I don't care what we do tonight. It's just going to be a war out here, and I'll do anything and everything. And that's why the no disqualification. That's why the falls count in and out of the ring. And that's why he's doing what he's doing right now. Fritz, in his early days in this business, was a tiger in the ring. He still is a tiger. What I mean by that, he was probably the roughest man in all wrestling. As Bundy goes to the floor of Texas Stadium.
A great example of Fritz in his young days. Just look at any one of his sons. Very evident of how Fritz used to wrestle. A great shot of Fritz there on the rope. The heat following the older Fritz a little bit. It's about 103 in the ring right now. If anybody's to be hurt by the heat tonight, it's a larger man, and that's Bundy at 475 pounds.
Oh, Bundy looking back. Knows he's got a problem. Fritz. There's a little psych job again. Bundy knows it. And Bundy's eyes show his concern.
Fritz here to teach Bundy a lesson, teach him something that he hasn't had, and that's respect. You don't turn on the people that break you into the business. And that's what Bundy is doing. Fritz is determined to teach Bundy something that he doesn't know anything about, and that's respect.
Now one side off the other. Here comes Fritz Vonerick to the floor of Texas Stadium.
Oh, no.
Into the post. Bundy's battered into the corner post. Now is Fritz Vonerick. He's determined. Wants the American Heavyweight Championship for the 10th time. And again, he batters Bundy into the corner.
Keep it in the ring. Come on, both of you. Back
first the head, then the shoulder.
David Manning trying to get both fighters back into the ring where the action should take place. Very dangerous action outside of the ring due to the post. But in one of the stipulations of the match, the match can go anywhere throughout Texas Stadium. I'm looking forward to both getting in back into the ring so we get things back on track here.
Bundy slow getting back. Fritz in a hurry to get back.
Come on.
Here comes Fritz. Bundy trying to get back in. On Erich all over this man.
Fritz
man with a mission.
Fritz really not letting Bundy get on track. Here comes the claw.
On the head, the master of the Iron Claw applies it as only he can. It is rather like taking a grape and squeezing it until the seed pops out.
You know, Bill, I've seen Fritz use this claw many, many times. His sons use it many times. But I've never seen him have a claw on this strong. Unbelievable tension in his hand.
David Manning wants it to break because Bundy is down into the ropes in the corner, but Fritz is not breaking it as yet. Now he breaks it, and there goes Bundy. Staggering, concerned, knocking over the stairs into the ring. Oh, Fritz, king of all he observes right now, as Bundy tries to shake off the effect of that devastating Iron Claw.
A lot of strength for a man that's been in the business 28 years. Unbelievable amount of strength. Bundy can't get going. Here comes Fritz outside of the ring after Bundy. This action can take place. Here they are in the end zone.
In the ring, out of the ring, Fritz has been in charge. Fritz goes again with a claw.
Bundy in big trouble. I don't know how much longer he can handle this claw, being that all the strength that Fritz has in his arm on this claw. I've never seen him use the claw this effective.
Bundy rips across the eyes, though, and breaks it. Bundy needs to try to regroup and figure out how he can come back now. King Kong Bundy.
Oh, no. It looks like Bundy's getting a chair.
Picking up that chair beside the scoring table. Here comes Bundy. And Bundy loses the chair. A kick to the midsection. Now Fritz comes back with the chair, and Bundy is in real trouble. Across the top of the head. Bundy staggered to his knees. Another one across the top of the head. The foot of the chair caught him. Now Fritz Von Erich moving in.
Bundy in trouble, not knowing where he is. He's on his back. He's in bad shape right now. Here goes Fritz for the pin.
One. Two. Three. Fritz Von Erich wins the American Heavyweight Championship in the end zone at Texas Stadium.
I had the iron claw on this guy as tight as I ever had it in my life on anybody.
We could tell that in the tight shots.
So you're going to have to pin him. Use a chair or whatever. Of course, in most matches, you can't do what I was able to do here tonight. But the gratifying thing is, Bill, I'm going out. But I'm going out with a belt that's meant the most to me and my family all these years.
And now you get a chance for this guy and the one behind you over here and David. Someday there'll be a national wrestling alliance champion.
One right now.
Here's another one. 10 times.
Each of these boys.
Here they are.
And this one are gonna be world heavyweight champions.
Well, we get 5 of them.
I'm dedicating my life to it.
Good.
And we'll have 5 champions.
Great, great.
10-time champ.
Of my 6 sons is Kevin. Old Kevin has been a great athlete all of his life. I can truthfully tell you that in all my years in this world, I have never seen a more versatile and all-around athlete than Kevin.
My brother Kevin was the fastest wrestler to ever, the quickest wrestler to ever enter that ring.
Now, I'm the oldest of my brothers, and Terry Gordy is kind of the big brother image of the Freebirds, and I felt like we really had a little something to settle just between the two of us, just him and me. I'll never forget the night we wrestled for that American Heavyweight Championship. When I hit that ring and I could hear that crowd, Kevin, Kevin, it just gave me a surge of energy, a surge of adrenaline that I think is probably what carried me through that match. I did get the win over Gordy, and I'll have to attribute some of that victory to the people in the sportatorium that night.
There's the face of Kevin Von Erich as he puts everything he has from that powerful upper body onto that headlock around Terry Gordy. Kevin is in as good a shape as he's ever been in. Bronco Lubitsch checking in. Terry Gordy's down. Kevin trying to get the upper hand here, get things going his way, and weaken that man for a possible pin and a victory. Kevin still holding on to Gordy with that headlock. Gordy squirming around, trying to come up with something to get him out of that. Kevin again reinforces that lock. And Gordy's knee looks a little weak now as he comes back to his feet. To the ropes they go. Across, Kevin back, and down goes the big man. Gordy tries to drag it over, but it's Kevin who pulls him across. Gordy doesn't exactly know where he is, but Kevin does, and Kevin comes right back with that iron with Gordy down flat on his back. And there's the knee on the muscle part of the arm. Pain on the face of Terry Gordy. One of the Freebirds. And keep in mind, Freebirds can come out of nowhere, as you have seen before. Kevin Von Erich. We've seen the legs and the high-flying abilities tonight. Here they are in that powerful pinning ability. The leg scissors right around that big midsection of Terry Gordy. Gordy has been unable to get anything going his way in the opening stages of this bout. As Kevin, with great strength in the thighs and calves, continues to hold on to Gordy, who's now trying to look like perhaps go to the rope. Better guard against the pin here, but he gets both arms under him and posts himself up somehow. Gordy in excruciating pain now as Kevin Von Erich really lets him have it with those leg scissors right around the midsection. And listen to the crowd chant for Kevin. They want to see him the American champion. Now still in the leg scissors, but on top here. Kissing and gasping for breath. Kevin now pushes away on the face. Kevin still holding on to those scissors. There's a count. Kevin had that both shoulders down there for just a moment. Gordy with a drive on the head. And again, and our cameras are right there. Gordy now drives that head under the turnbuckle. Holds him across. What's he going to do now? Kevin comes across and puts him in the leg scissors around the midsection yet another time. We're into the second five-minute segment of this main event. Kevin Von Erich and Terry Gordy for the American Heavyweight Championship. Gordy tries to come up with a drive, and the leg scissors weakening. That time, he knocks Kevin away, but Kevin comes up over, pulls him across. One, two, but Gordy pops the head with the leg. The crowd roaring with excitement. They thought Kevin had him. There's a leapfrogging headbutt. And a drive solidly across the back. Now one by Gordy to the side of the head. An elbow. Kevin throws Gordy to the ropes. Back, and it's the abdominal stretch by Kevin Von Erich, and listen to the crowd. Kevin puts Gordy in that abdominal stretch and grabs a hold of that midsection for just even more punishment. Puts it in kind of a crawl there on the side, but Gordy, in a magnificent show of strength, rolls Kevin across his back. And both men a little bit slow to come back. Kevin charges, and it's a knee in the midsection. This is a hard-fought bout already. And Kevin threatens the claw. He won't quite get it on that forehead. Gordy defending. Just how close Kevin is to putting that iron claw Von Erich style on that forehead. Just a matter of inches. Gordy holding him off for all he can. Is he fighting a losing battle? No, he's not. Kevin's attempt is thwarted. Gordy lurks back over, and there's a powerful right. It's clenched. And Kevin rolls across that top rope. Kevin with a drop kick. He just caught him with his heels. Gordy with the kick. Each man must use his head as well as his body to win this title bout. Kevin back and puts Gordy in a sleeper. Is in a sleeper by Kevin Von Erich. Look at the expression on the face of Terry Gordy as he gasps for breath. Gordy in agony. Gordy rolls over to his side. Kevin still holding on. The fans cheering as Kevin has Gordy all tied up, and Bronco Lubitsch checks that arm to see if Gordy's still there. And he is, but just barely. This is for the American Heavyweight Championship. A prestigious belt which lies just under the World Heavyweight Championship. Kevin still holding on, trying to weaken that big freebird. And Gordy finally gets a foot to the rope. Kevin is there with a kick and a stomp. And the ropes, Kevin goes, and it's Gordy now. Gordy with Kevin Von Erich in that sleeper. And Kevin reaches for the ropes, and Gordy restrains him. listen to this crowd now. They're really roaring. Kevin Von Erich reaching for the ropes. Now trying to push back to his feet. He has a lot of strength and weight on him. Reeling. Kerry has all the wind knocked out of him, and this crowd is really low. Kerry moves back in, but Kevin is there. Kerry the turnbuckle. All the way across, and Kerry pays another visit to the club. We're into the third 5-minute segment now. Erich has him on that rope. Look out, he's choking him and smashing his throat and face down on that rope and pulls him back. Erich now with the momentum on his side of the ring. Professional wrestler with great resiliency. And Kevin Von Erich is illustrating that. Kevin pushes Bronco a little bit out of the way, but Gordy is there to grab him. Kevin dishing out the punch for now. And look out. They're in the face. Jackie wants to put him up with a suplex, yes. Down he goes, hard, and Kevin bounces. One, two, and this bout is not over yet. The title bout's always intense. Oh, no, here comes a pile driver. Gordy wants to pile drive Kevin, but Kevin is able to throw him back into the corner, and thank goodness. The pile driver always so scary, and he's going to try it again. Look out. Kevin just won't go down, and he throws Gordy over. An unbelievable move by Kevin. Gordy tried twice to pile drive him. And they're in the corner now. That could have been the turning point of this bout had that pile driver been successful. But Kevin will throw Gordy over. Gordy up, comes back, and Kevin ducks under and is out of the way. Kevin now, high in the air, leaping back and down on Gordy. One, two, three, and Kevin is the American heavyweight champion.
It's still the American heavyweight champion, Kevin Von Erich.
When I wrestled Terry Gordy, it seems like I used every hold I have in wrestling. It seemed like I had to use it all on him because he is a really tough individual. But I came out the winner, and so the bottom line is I won the match.
There's Sunshine, there's gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, and here comes David Von Erich. And the little lady is right in the middle. Rocco Lubitsch is trying to calm things. Oh, Sunshine with a right hand. Whoa, good gracious. The Garvin's out of the ring. Garvin and David Von Erich backing Sunshine after that right hand to the head. And pandemonium at the State Fair Coliseum.
And Gary Hart continues to work on Fritz Von Erich. And now David Manning kicks Gary Hart away, but there, believe, could have been a karate chop. A karate chop, possibly in the throat, but there is no disqualification. And now a choking. And here comes David Von Erich. Here comes David Von Erich into the ring. He goes after Kabuki. He goes after Gary Hart. David Von Erich coming in as Fritz Von Erich was in deep, deep trouble. David Von Erich and Kabuki. It is David Von Erich and Kabuki. And now Kabuki takes David down, and he goes back after Fritz. David Von Erich came in, and now a drop kick, and down goes Kabuki. There is no disqualification. This cannot be disqualification. A backdrop, and down goes Kabuki. David Von Erich says, cover him, Dad, cover him. Here comes Gary Hart. Gary Hart going after David. There's the count of one, two, and three, and it's over.
David's no longer here with us, but David's gone on ahead. And I do know one thing, that boy, if there's any wrestling in heaven, old David's the main eventer. He's a champion.
I'll never forget the time my brother Dave and I were in St. Louis, and he had his big shot to wrestle the world heavyweight champion. And the guy had put Dave down over and over again. Talked about how my brother was too young to be a contender, this and that. And I'll never forget the way I felt the day my brother Dave pinned the world heavyweight champion up there in his home turf in St. Louis.
Fritz Von Erich is incensed at the tactics of Race. Race mounts the ropes, the diving headbutt for the second rope. Oh, he caught him in the claw. He caught Race in the claw. David Von Erich with the iron claw and the world champion. Race diving off for the diving headbutt. David was waiting with the iron claw. David grinding away on the head of the world champ. Look how he's over him. He's sitting right over the world champion. Fritz and Kevin cheering on David Von Erich. Race caught in the iron claw of David Von Erich. The hold that Fritz invented and helped his son David perfect. What a move that was by David Von Erich, catching Race as he dove off the ropes with a claw. Now it's so important for Race. He's got to get to his feet. If he can't, look at the blood pouring out of the side of the head of Race. The blood pouring out of the head of Race. David Von Erich with the iron claw has opened up Race's head. Look at the blood streaming down the face of Harley Race. The iron claw opening up the head of the world champion. The blood pouring out of the head of Race. Race, totally desperate now. He's got to do something to get away from that claw. David Von Erich has opened up the head of Race with the iron claw. David trying to trip Race. David puts Race down. The blood smeared over the face, the chest, the arms of the world champion. David Von Erich showing that he can use the claw as well as his father ever has, because David is in there with the man who may very well be the toughest in professional wrestling today. I think Race is out. That's it. David Von Erich has beat the world champion with the iron claw.
The iron claw was something my brother Dave mastered. Now, he had hands, could easily palm a basketball, and I mean, catch a basketball with one hand and throw it all the way across the gym again. I mean, he had hands like you wouldn't believe. And when he took those big hands and stuck the claw in somebody, it was all over. There's nothing they could do. And Kamala knows darn well what I'm talking about.
Here comes Akbar into the arena. Kamala's with him, and what in the world are they doing here? Akbar pointing up to the ring. Timmy Garvin has a chin lock reversed on David. Here comes Kamala in. What in the world are they here for? This is something ludicrous on the part of Akbar. Now Bronco Lubitsch, looks like Akbar's after anybody. He's after David Von Erich. Kamala attacking David Von Erich. Kamala going after David Von Erich, undoubtedly on the orders of Akbar. Watch out, there's David Von Erich with the claw on Kamala. David Von Erich coming off the ropes. Kamala caught in that iron fist of David Von Erich. Kamala puts David down, and David comes back and has Kamala on his knees, and nobody puts Kamala down. But David Von Erich has him down. Now Kamala, 330 pounds, trying to come back. And David takes him all the way. David takes him down. The iron claw slides him around the ring. Humiliates Kamala. Humiliates Akbar. David Von Erich demonstrating tremendous tensile strength as he takes Kamala holds that devastating claw on Kamala. Now they're going to be able to save him, but David Von Erich has clawed Kamala.
Is declared by Bronco Lubitsch. Von Erich the winner.
David Von Erich the winner. Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin has just escaped into the backdrop as Kamala came in, and Kamala now has got ordered by Akbar to go back. Kamala says, well, I don't know what he says, but I think he was a little reluctant. He looks reluctant. Shakes his head, no. Kamala backs off. David Von Erich backs down Kamala. That's the first time we've seen anybody, anywhere, back down Kamala, put him down. There he is.
It was a cold night in February. About 2 o'clock in the morning, I got a phone call direct from Japan. That was when I heard the news that my brother was gone. A part of me died that night, all of my brothers.
They were almost 6'8", 275. Extremely quick, and I guess he's probably the most like his old dad, like me. He's 25 years old when he died.
It's tough to live with, but I'll tell you this, we are living with it. And instead of it bringing us down, instead of us hanging our heads about it, no way. My brother Dave lives in our hearts still, not just the memories, but we know that we'll be with our brother again someday, and he's alive with us in spirit. When my brother Dave died, my brother Kevin and I were both ranked in the top 10 in the world in wrestling. And because we were his brothers and Dave had a match already sanctioned by the NWA to wrestle the World Heavyweight title in Texas Stadium, well, my brother Dave died. And so the family all got together and we said, hey, we got a commitment to our brother Dave and we want that World Heavyweight title. We flipped a coin. Well, I won the toss. And so I guess you can imagine the weight that was on my shoulders at the time, because I had to take that World Heavyweight title. My brother David died. That was his dream. That was at the time, it was a bigger dream of his. It's a bigger dream of his than mine or Kevin's or anyone else in the family. David was going to be the Von Erich World Heavyweight Champion.
This event is for the World Heavyweight title. There are two stipulations of this title. First of all, there is no time limit. And also, if the champion should disqualify himself, he will automatically be forced to relinquish his title and give it to Kerry Von Erich.
This is it. Make no mistake where you are.
First of all, the heavyweight champion of the world from Minneapolis, weighing 235 pounds, Mr. Ric Flair.
The world has been waiting for this bout for months.
And his challenger, from Denton, Texas, weighing 259 pounds, Mr. Kerry Von Erich.
There are no seatbelts on the chairs here at Texas Stadium, but we almost need them. No time limit. If Kerry gets disqualified, he loses the belt. This is it. Here we go. The confidence on the face of Kerry Von Erich and the champion. We'll take just a moment to size this over again. 50,000 fans are here for this. This is what they've come to see. They're in the ropes, and the hold is broken. There is only one World Heavyweight Champion. He represents the entire world. Flair takes him down, can't find the handle, carry up and win it. This crowd, you can feel the tension amongst this mob. They will reserve their enthusiasm. And I may have spoken too soon because the roar begins to come. The chant, go, Kerry, go. They've brought signs. They've brought their voices. Flair can't find the handle. the favorite is always the champion in a bout like this. He has the experience. He's defended the belt so many times before against so many. But in light of the circumstances that have put Kerry in this ring today, so many, many favor Kerry. World Class Championship Wrestling bringing this all to you. What a great show it's been. What a great show last week. Down goes Flair. Kerry to the ropes. Leapfrog with the champion. Kerry turns up. Kick down goes Flair. Kerry's there again. And the champion cows in the corner. Referee stance turns into a side headlock by Kerry Von Erich. The champion pushes him up and off. Kerry with that tremendous physique. Well, look at the muscles in those arms. Even as he is bent down, and now the thing begins to go the other way as Flair is taken down. The Von Erich dream is underway. Kerry with the iron bar. The Von Erich name has been meant so much to professional wrestling, all of sports, all of society, as their example inside the ring and outside the ring in the real world has meant so much to so many. Here's the champion charging into Kerry with a shoulder. He's in the corner, slapping Kerry, and the fans can hear it all through the stadium. Rolling now. Flair back to his feet. There's a drive by Kerry. Kerry has him high. Power slam, and down goes the champion, the Nature Boy. We've seen him before. We heard what he had to say in advance weeks, previous weeks, coming into this via taped interviews. And now we're seeing the bout. Flair out on the floor. The count has begun. David Manning with the count. And Flair back in before it even gets close. On a beautiful, warm afternoon at Texas Stadium, the largest crowd ever. As Ric Flair, perhaps, in fact, without a doubt, his toughest test ever in defending the World Heavyweight Championship, and he's defending it a few times. Flair has so much. The mind, the body, it all has to work together. And Kerry Von Erich reaching that same level. Kerry has worked so hard. He's been on world tour in recent weeks. Kerry on his knees. There's a chop by the champion, Kerry, into the ropes. The champion has gained momentum, and Kerry goes to the floor. Kerry right back like nothing ever happened, but Flair is waiting for him. Kerry with a headbutt from the apron. Kerry over sunset flip. But Flair reaches for the rope. Will he go down? Yes. One, two, and the leg scissors. You could see it coming. Oh, the level of intensity is so high in this crowd and amongst this crowd. They leap to their feet with every kick count. Kerry wants to put him out. The sleeper. Oh, Both men slow to get back to their feet. Here's a flying mare by the champion, Kerry down. The champion backs away to the far rope. And it's a knee across the head. Kerry Von Erich on his knees. The champion wants David Manning out of the way. A thrill for David Manning to get to officiate this world title bout. Here's the suplex, and down goes Kerry. The champion will have his first pin of this bout. Two, look out, oh. Drop kick by Kerry. Flair was not expecting that. And Flair moves right back over with an elbow. Is this? Who's going to get in the abdominal stretch? It's Kerry stretching out the champion, Ric Flair. Abdominal stretch, and we're in position for a possible submission. But in a world title situation, I'm not sure you'd ever see it.
What's the tights?
Flair yelling about the tights. Tosses Kerry over. Point, great camera work and great audio. Here's Kerry back on his feet. A knee across the champion's head. Kerry down. Yes, it's Kerry. Flair with the tights gets a knee in the midsection. Down goes Kerry, Flair to the rope. And it's a iron claw. Kerry Von Erich with that patented, unique Von Erich iron claw. No one else can do it like the Von Erichs, and Flair is paralyzed. Look at this crowd, listen to them.
What's the bell? Oh, nothing below the bell.
David Manning warning Flair about that blow which he just delivered to Kerry Von Erich. Both men on their knees. It's hot in that ring out there. And this is the toughest bout probably either of these men will ever be in. Look out. The champion climbing, carries on his feet. Grabs him. Takes him out and throws him across Texas Stadium. Kerry with the drive, the champion in the corner. Flair upside down, falling back. Good grief, Charlie Brown. Kerry with a right. Flying there. Step over toe hold, but Kerry puts a stop to that by kicking the champion away. Another step over attempt, and Kerry knocks him away a second time. Here's Flair from the ropes, wants to toss Kerry across. Kerry's got him. Here's the Nelson pin. Two, three! The dream comes true! Yes!
Kerry Von Erich.
The day has come. And the dream has come true.
I'll be back. There ain't gonna be any trouble. I'll be back. You tell your brothers, you tell your old man, Ric Flair, I'll be back.
You got it, baby. You got it, Chet.
has a smile on his face at this very moment. Kerry fighting his way through the mobs and heading for the back, and there's Fritz. You can see Fritz von Erich in the background. Fritz there to greet Kerry. There's Mrs. von Erich. Kerry's mother.
Once again, the new World Heavyweight Champion, Kerry.
As it was put before my brother David, coming from myself, I love that guy more than I loved anything in the whole world. And all of a sudden he up and died on us. The Lord called him. But I guess that was the opportunity when my brother Mike stepped in.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to welcome to Reunion Arena for his first professional wrestling bout, Mike von Erich.
Before I went into the ring, my mouth went completely dry. I had butterflies in my stomach. My brothers told me when I first stepped in that ring to take my first lesson in professional wrestling. They told me to expect some pain. I had a big, big spot to fill because I had a lot of people down on all the Von Erich family.
And of course, he's upholding, as all these brothers have said, the honor of the Von Erich family, starting with Fritz. Have it right to Kevin, David, and Kerry. Here's Mark.
What more needs to be said but just a fabulous hello and the best of luck during his career for the man from Denton County, Texas, continuing the great Von Erich legend, 215 pounds, Michael Von Erich. His first ever professional opponent, the man known as the General of Devastation Incorporated, 245 pounds, General Skandor Akbar.
Perfect opening for it. And here, as the brothers said, is the best athlete of them all, Mike von Erich. You got to be a little nervous when you open your professional debut of any kind before a sold-out house of some 18 to 20,000. When you see a Mike von Erich, you look at those shoulders, you look at those arms, you know where he's been, working out, lifting weights, pushing that iron around. And of course, he's been learning from his older brothers, a great athlete himself in football, track, field, basketball, everything. He's done it all. And he's a strong young man. Shoving Skandor Akbar about. So this match is a feud match. And of course, whoa, look out. He learns. Shook himself up. Now here comes Skandor Akbar across. He's got a chance right here to give the rookie a lesson or two. And he goes to work and not holding back. Of course, Skandor Akbar has been after the Von Erichs for a long time. And now here's the newest one to punish. And Fritz von Erich's got to be chewing a fingernail or two, as are the other von Erich brothers. Skandor Akbar, of course, not only can handle himself as a rough, tough man here, but he owns the rights to Kamala. Works with the others. Works with the Super Destroyers. Works with a lot of characters that are known as rough and tough. Now, what is Akbar asking for now? A whip. Oh, that's using an object. But no, Michael von Erich's got it turned upside down. Three. Akbar lost his concentration. Then he fried it, a hand in the whip. And Michael von Erich. Here comes Kevin right behind him. And
Michael
has the whip, and Michael takes after him and goes after him again. Kevin von Erich came up, ran into Friday, and Michael Mike Olbon, Erich wins his professional wrestling debut.
You know, a lot of wrestlers underestimate my little brother Mike. Now, he only weighs 225 pounds, and to you folks at home, that sounds like a heck of a lot of weight. But when you're wrestling 300-pound men, they could look at a 225-pounder as a guy that's a lightweight. Well, let me tell you, there have been a lot of guys surprised by my baby brother Mike.
They're in the ropes. They come back. It's a bear hug by John Tatum, and Mike Von Erich is falling or else thrown over that top rope. Both men are down. Who will get up? Rick has him in the count. Tatum is up first. Big John has a hold of Mike, has him in the ropes, wants to throw him. Comes back. Mike ducks under the clothesline. Comes back, ducks under a second time. This time it's a splash. One, two, three. Mike Von Erich wins.
Mike was looking at a future of greatness. Then a short time later, Mike went into the hospital for a simple surgical procedure on his left shoulder, and toxic shock set in.
When he was released from the hospital on Monday, he was in very good, perfect condition. The surgery had gone well, he had healed well, and thought that he was well on the road to recovery. His condition at the present time remains critical, as it has been since yesterday.
Last night was really scary. I mean, scary to the point of where it was almost hopeless. And we have some of the elders of the church, First Baptist in Dallas, and folks, let me tell you, a miracle took place last night, just that we have Mike with us today.
At one point, they came and told us that Mike didn't stand a chance, that Mike could not make it. The outside, he had 20 minutes left in this world. Every major organ in his body had shut down. His kidneys had just collapsed. No blood pressure. And 107 temperature for hours.
The hospital had over 400 phone calls an hour for over 2 weeks straight about my brother Mike. Is he gonna live? Finally, a doctor came to Kevin and I and said, your brother only has 20 minutes to live. You can go see, the doctor said, you can go see him, or you can go talk to your family, or what? Well, we didn't go talk to our family, we didn't go see him, we got on our knees and prayed. When we got up off our knees from praying, the doctor was behind us, and he said, your brother's made a turn for the better, and we think he's gonna make it.
I didn't know about any of this, but I knew that I had all that love on me. I was just so moved by my family being there. And then later hearing about how they'd gone on TV and asked the fans to pray for me. And that's the only reason I'm alive here today, is because I had all those prayers for me that the Lord answered.
Let me just say this about Mike. He is a champion, and this boy will come back. It may take time. The big thing is we have him back now. The other things are nothing compared to what we just went through. And Mike will be back. You take that from his old dad. He'll be back and he'll be a champion again.
I'm pleased to present to you a living miracle. Welcome to the Cotton Bowl, Mike Von Erich. But now he's in the midst of the leg scissors and upside down. Mike Von Erich takes him over. And Hacksaw Reed finds out that Mike Von Erich is more than ready to return to the world of world-class and professional wrestling. Mike Von Erich with a drop kick to Matt Bourne. He has now successfully cleared the ring of all three contenders for this coveted World Six-Man Tag Team title. And Kevin Von Erich knows what he has seen. Mike ready to return.
ICU. That means intensive care.
This is absolutely horrible. Mike has been hit once. He's being restrained by Michael Hayes. With a chair.
My little brother Chris is so explosive. He is so explosive.
Lord, but... Chris fought Erich tackling here. The young Chris fought Erich tackling as he came across our table.
One day, I'm afraid, just like the wrestling magazines say, he is going to shock the world. He's the kid that is going to lead the Von Erichs into the future.
The Von Erichs are the greatest six-man world tag team I think it's ever been, and that's because we were brothers. Well, the Freebirds claim that they're brothers, which actually they're not. But they'd been building for a long, long time. But up to this match, we were used to wrestling against the Freebirds. But that night, it was Buddy Roberts, Michael Hayes, and Jim Garvin. Terry Gordy got trapped in Japan, was not able to get in. Jim Garvin, being a buddy of theirs, being a friend, stepped in and wrestled with them. Jim Garvin's tough. And Buddy Roberts, he's a tough guy. He's tougher than nails. And then Michael Hayes, who has a bigger mouth than anybody else in the business, but he is a great wrestler. When my brothers and I stepped into that ring that night, we weren't stepping in for the Von Erich brothers, but we were stepping in for Texas.
Michael Hayes and David Von Erich opening up this six-man non-championship fight. Here's Buddy Roberts coming in. They work on David Von Erich. Underneath, but on top. Whoa, does Buddy Roberts fly, and here comes Kerry Von Erich, and now the Von Erichs have it all worked out. And I gotta give him a ride and a triple drop kick. Woo.
As a three-man team, it was the greatest experience of all time. It was it's an incredible experience to have two guys on your team that you really believed with all your heart were the greatest wrestlers in the whole world.
Buddy Roberts caught up in the excitement with Kerry Von Erich. Buddy Roberts, who was dethroned by Bruiser Brody, and look at Kevin Von Erich flying in. The acrobatic, aerobatic Kevin Von Erich, and right away gives Buddy Roberts a headache. And right away he goes to the eyes and the protective gear of Buddy Roberts. Oh, a battle with all the Freebirds and all the Von Erichs will be fantastic. Buddy Roberts with a headbutt to the midsection of Kevin Von Erich. And now here comes gorgeous Jimmy Garvin as Kevin is set up. And Garvin has a chance with Kevin shaken. Looks like Buddy Roberts got a foot or a toe in the eye when Kevin Von Erich hit him a moment ago.
When my brother Kev and Dave and I, we stepped into that ring, it was like magic. I mean, when a brother is hurt, the other two brothers realize it. The other two brothers feel it. And so they know, hey, get in there and save that brother.
And here comes Kerry back. Got a little suplex action here. And Roberts does it quite well. Trying to get a pin. One, two, and not enough for three. But here's Michael Hayes in. And Michael is geared up and keyed up right now. He's got a chance against a very, very tough warrior, Kerry Von Erich, and a tremendous tooth-rattling elbow to the mouth. Into the knee of gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. And now it's Garvin, Hayes, and Roberts who have everything going their way. This, as again, is not a championship match. It's just sort of a warm-up and a prelude to what we hope will be one soon. There's a count of two and on and up for three. Garvin trying to put Kerry Von Erich away, but not that way. Here comes David. David Von Erich and gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. And Garvin is in the center of the ring, but not liking it too much. And David Von Erich now, caught in the back of the head. They're looking along the next week. Michael Hayes and Kerry Von Erich have a bout together, and that's got to be an exciting one, a promising one. David Von Erich, crashed by Buddy Roberts. Michael Hayes gives him a hand. Buddy with a hard right hand to the jaw, and the Von Erich boys right now are in trouble. Roberts commanding attention, but David Von Erich has taken it right away from him. Up and over, watch this move, crunch! I think Buddy decided David would probably go underneath. They both went up, and now the count is on. Can they get up by 10? Can they make it by 10? Michael Hayes being counted because he's helping Buddy Roberts. Here comes gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and Kevin Von Erich in the championship type battle right here. Look at Kevin. He is aflame. Aflame with desire to take care of Garvin. And now the wild melee. There goes Kevin out one side. Kerry with his discus throw missed. But Garvin goes back. David Von Erich has Buddy Roberts trying to take the mask and the helmet off and the hair off. Kevin on top of gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. One, two, three. And the Von Erichs beat the Freebirds and one.
I've had people ask me who I love the most. Man, how do you say something like that? I love all my kids.
When we're in the ring, it's one for all and all for one. We think alike. And we love each other.
We consider every day we live to be a blessing, and we're thankful that for every day we have together. As we're a real close family, we do everything we can together, and there's nothing can ever come between the Von Erichs. We're too tight.
Hope you've enjoyed all the exciting Von Erich matches on Front Row Ringside. Coming soon, the Von Erich family story, as we retrace the moments of triumph and tragedy in the lives of America's favorite wrestling family. We'll take you places you've never seen before and show you a side of the Von Erichs you've never known. You'll learn about the family's hobbies and retrace the past decade as seen through Kerry's personal photo albums. You'll never be closer to the Von Erich family than in this exclusive videotape featuring never-before-seen footage. Stay tuned to World Class Championship Wrestling on your local television station for details.